I think a few things went wrong. Mainly, we kind of let them get their confidence in the second half, let them get some shots coming out, and their zone kind of messed us up a little bit. We didn't get good shots and quality looks in the second half.
What is it about the zone defense that it seems like it's been a few times this year where you guys have been rolling on offense, the zone has thrown y'all off? What is it that, I mean, coaches said y'all practice it and practice, but what keeps it from translating into a game, do you think?
I'm not sure, because we definitely practice and go over different plays and things to attack the zone, but so far it hasn't translated to the game to help us, you know, execute down the stretch.
How much of that is youth, do you think? How much of it is it, you know, not adjusting early enough? Like, what is it, youth? What is it, do you think?
Honestly, I don't know what it is. I don't think it's youth. I just think we get caught up in the flow of the game and kind of sometimes forget to think the game instead of, you know, just reacting and playing.
What about defensively in the second half of games? You guys have really kind of let your guard down in terms of teams starting to get really hot against you guys. Mm-hmm. Any rhyme or reason on that?
I don't think there's any reason. I just think a couple lapses on defense can gain confidence for the other team. So I just think we got to try to focus and, you know, settle in throughout the whole game and not just the first half or a few minutes, but the whole 40 minutes.
What was the name of the conference you played in Northeastern?
Colonia.
Yeah. What have been some of your observations of the just the basketball style and you know, talent in the SEC? Is it markedly different, markedly better?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would say SEC has a lot better athletes. It's quicker pace, you know, getting up and down the floor, you know, high scoring. Like I said, everyone's an athlete. Everyone can run, jump, and at a high level. So definitely difference.
What are some things you guys need to do well against Alabama?
I think we got to contain them. They're a really fast team on the offensive transition side. So we got to contain them, contain the dribble, don't overhelp, and make them, you know, take tough contested twos.
You hit a pretty big three there down the stretch in Florida. I think I was the only one you took in the game. How do you decide who shoots three? I see Rayshon taking five or six threes, and you only take one.
We kind of just, you know, just go with the flow. Whoever, you know, kind of has the open look, kind of just take it. I don't think we try to count each other's shots during the game. We kind of just take what the defense gives us.
Going forward, you know, say you guys were to build a big lead tomorrow in Alabama, which is if that happens, you guys miss a couple shots. How do you keep it from snowballing like you have, you know, against Florida and in other games?
I think we got to take it possession at a time. In Florida, I think we kind of let them hit a couple shots early and let them get their confidence. So I think if we get up again like that, we need to lock in on defensive end. And we know the offense will come, so just, you know, focus on defense and get one stop in a row at a time.
Does the problems in the defensive end get you out of rhythm on the offensive end? Did that happen at all against Florida, do you think?
I think that can happen. I don't think that was the main problem. But, you know, when they got the scoring and the crowd got involved, you know, the confidence was just crazy at that time.
Might be an obvious question, but, I mean, just that flight back that night. I mean, just what's that like after a game like that?
It's tough. It's tough to sleep after a loss like that, definitely because we lost Missouri in a similar way. So, I mean, it's tough to regroup, but we had a good practice yesterday and looking to rebuild on that today. Get ready for Alabama.
Do you guys dwell on those losses at all, kind of like use them for motivation, or do you guys kind of just like scratch it and move on?
We try to use it for motivation. It's hard when you know we should win a few games. It's hard to, you know, kind of get over that, but we're trying to just say what we can do next game, get better, and just keep improving.
Obviously, like, the crowd play into it. I mean, I was watching from the couch, but it seemed
pretty good. Yeah, second half, they definitely got into it. In the first half, you know, we were making shots and things like that, so they couldn't really, you know, get into the game. But once they hit a couple buckets in a row, crowd definitely got involved and played a role.